हरे कृष्ण माता जी हैप्पी युगादी
हैप्पी उगादि मनवे कृष्ण हैप्पी उगादि तांत्रिक हैप्पी उगादि
व्हाट इज उगारी माताजी
उगादि इज आवर न्यू ईयर माताजी तेलुगु पीपल न्यू ईयर
ओह योर न्यू ईयर आवर आल्सो
ओह यू आर आल्सो न्यू ईयर टुडे
yes 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 our also today or tomorrow but our new year
ma'am oh yeah yeah even some people are doing even ours also today and tomorrow some people are doing today some people are doing tomorrow yes
also Dani was asking what is ugari before also everyone is saying
oh okay it's new year our calendar like how American calendar starts on January like that is our calendar starts
mommy I'm on a show
yeah Hare Krishna, welcome to the Damodar class today. Yeah, Vrinda wanted to show today's activity. So today we are drawing Krishna like this. If you all have a paper, pencil, and please draw Krishna. I will tell what to do after drawing Krishna.
Yeah, you have to name. So you can just put a little space and draw the contours and everything. That's what we are gonna do.
Yeah, we will do what we will. See what we are going to do with that Krishna picture.
Gauri Mata ji.
Hare Krishna. Okay, let's start with the prayers.
Did I start the recording?
Okay, I start the recording.
Om Ajnana Timirandasya
Asya Ajnana Jana Shalakaya Chakshuram Ninitam Nena Tasmai Sri Guruve Nama Chaitanya namo bhishtam sthapitam yena bhutale svayam rupa pradamayam yena vishvapadantikam
antikam
namo om vishnu padaya krishna prishtaya bhutale shrimate bhakti vedanta swami niti namine namaste saraswati deve gauravani pracharine nirvishesha shunyavadi Vashatadeshatarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Nivasani Prabhakaranda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Balavrinda, Hare Krishna Tushita. Who else?
Don't want to forget me.
Yes. Ram Sridhar. Who is that Ram Sridhar? Is a new one.
Yeah.
Shobhan. That is also, I see the new name. I don't know who all they. Welcome, whoever is new. Welcome to the call. Thank you so much for joining. Today's story is Srinivasa Acharya meets Gadadhar Pandit. Let's see how Srinivasa Acharya meets Gadadhar Pandit. The beginning of that, there is small explanation how this Kali Yuga, people are, everybody are forgetting about God consciousness. It's so sad, right? People don't have any consciousness of God. They are just living like animals. They don't want it to know about God. So it is very sad. Our actual goal of life is to understand the purpose of our life is that we are the servant of Krishna and we need to serve Krishna. Then only we can go back to God. And how this can be understood only when we study Bhagavatam, then we can understand. So for this reason only, it's very, very important for us to read Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam is full of the stories how devotees surrendered to Krishna and Krishna always helping them. So we can see many stories like that and we learn so many things, how we should not do mistake. And how our purpose of life is not to be doing sense gratification, but doing serving for Krishna. So Bhagavatam explains all of this. So when the son of Chaitanya Dasa, Srinivasa, was 16 years, so he immediately wanted to know the purpose of the life and he wanted to study Bhagavatam. So he wanted to study Bhagavatam from the bona fide spiritual master. We all know Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So Srinivasa wanted to learn Bhagavatam from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So then he goes to Jagannath Puri. While going also, he was always thinking about mind. He was always thinking about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Like when he went there, he saw that many people were crowded over there in Jagannath Puri. Then he was seeing what is going on here. Then everybody said, it's a big festival now. What's the festival? You know, that is a little sad, but it's also a festival. What is that? He's like, you know, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went inside the temple of Jagannath Puri. After that, he's not coming out. He's just went, means he went to back to Godhead. So it's little sad, but always Lord Krishna's appearance and disappearance is always the celebrating. So they are all celebrating the disappearance of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So then Srinivasa Acharya was so sad. Oh, now who is going to teach me Bhagavatam? I came all the way from so far, to Jagannath Puri to learn Bhagavatam. So he was crying, and he fell down. And when he fell down and he was crying like that, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes into his dream and he says that you don't worry, you know. Don't worry, Gadadhar is there. He will teach you Bhagavatam. You can go to him. He will teach you Bhagavatam. So then by hearing these, still Gadadhar Pandit did not go back to God. He's still there. So then when hearing these words, Srinivasa, what he did, you know, he went to Gadadhar Pandit. But Gadadhar Pandit, what happened, you know, he was so sad. Because Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went, right? Everybody is in separation. He was also crying. But as soon as he saw Srinivasa, because Gadadhar also knows that, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu only has sent this Srinivasa. So by seeing him, he immediately, thinks that, okay, what do you want? Then he asked that, please teach me Bhagavatam only. I only have the hope of you. Please teach me Bhagavatam. Then Gadadhar immediately says that, this your Bhagavatam is completely wet because you cried so much. All Bhagavatam is gone. Those days, no printed ones. All are, written ones, right? So then Gadadhar says, how can I read now? Nothing is there in this. Everything is gone because you cried. Everything is gone. So then he says, okay, I will go and get the another copy. So he goes to Navadvip and gets some other copy from there. There are different scholars who were having the Bhagavatam. So then from there, he will get another Bhagavatam and go back to Jagannath Puri, and Gadadhar reads all Bhagavatam. So here we can see the importance of Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam has lots and lots of importance. So Bhagavatam means Krishna himself. If you see here, Lord Krishna in front of you, right? How many cantos whole Bhagavatam has? Anybody knows in the class?
I know, Mataji.
Yes, tell me, Janavi, how many cantos?
12. Matri has
12 cantos, right? So 12 cantos, Bhagavata means it's a sound incarnation of Lord. It is a book, but it is Krishna himself. Okay, I request everybody to please mute. Okay, nobody is unmute. Okay, Tanvik. Okay, thank you, kids. So, Lord Krishna himself is a form of Lord himself in the sound incarnation is called Bhagavatam. So, Bhagavatam is divided like this. See, the two lotus feet of the Lord is called the first and second canto are the lotus feet of the Lord. So, you come from down and go up. Even when you are taking darshan of the Lord, you cannot directly take Lord's face. So, we need to be coming from the town, when you go to the temple hall, you first do your pranam to Srila Prabhupada and then you walk in. So then where you see Lord, right? You cannot see directly Lord like this. You go from the bottom, see the lotus feet, do the pranam over there and slowly you move up. So first canto and second canto are the lotus feet of the Lord. And the third and fourth cantos are the thighs of the Lord. Fifth canto is navel of the Lord. Sixth canto is the chest of the Lord. Seventh and eighth cantos are arms of the Lord.
So now we are going to write that thing.
Ninth canto is the throat of the Lord. Tenth canto is a beautiful lotus face of the Lord. And the 11th canto is a forehead. And the 12th is a top and head. So like this, when you go slowly, we can go one after the other. So this picture I will be sending into the WhatsApp group also. You all can see and write it, mark it. And wait, I will send now only. Okay, I will send a screenshot. Okay, by then you can see like this. So like that, it is very, very important. And it is said that one who reads the Bhagavatam should not read directly whatever canto they want. They have to go systematically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, like that. They cannot go whatever they want to do. No, like that. And also it is said...
Can I show you what I have done? I did this
one. One second. Let me finish this and I will see you. Definitely, I will see you. So then also, what is it says, if somebody is reading one and two cantos, again and again, because it's a lotus feet of the Lord, right? It describes lotus feet of the Lord. So lotus feet of the Lord removes all our sins. Everything, the mountain like sins are there, but when we take shelter of this Srimad Bhagavatam and read these cantos 1, 9, 2 again and again to understand more and more, then our all sins will go away. So Bhagavatam is really, really very, very important in this Kali Yuga. We have to take shelter of this Bhagavatam, because Bhagavatam explains us how to come out of all of these material problems. Okay, and how do we understand Bhagavatam? The good way to understand Bhagavatam is through Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was showing us a pure devotion to Lord Krishna, and he's our spiritual master. So he came in the mode of a devotee. And when we understand Lord Srimad Bhagavatam through Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then it is perfect understanding. So even we also did all Gaurakatha, we did everything, all Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we learned everything. So now it's a time for all of us to read Bhagavatam also. Soon we are going to start that also in our Damodar classes. We'll be having so fun learning Bhagavatam also. So this is the canto. See, 12 cantos we have and 18,000 verses, 332 chapters we have in Bhagavatam. So this is what I explain you all. Yeah, so who want to show me? I will stop this
screen. I want to show mine.
Who want to? Tanvik, right? Tanvik, show me.
I made this.
So please, this side, move this side. I cannot see it. Now we can see it. Beautiful, Dhanvik. So beautiful. Post it, okay?
Yeah, I'll post it. I write book Bhagavata Lord Krishna.
Very good, very good.
Hare Krishna Mataji, it's Deepak. I joined late when we were saying Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya, that time I joined, so I didn't draw anything.
That's okay, that's okay. You can draw a little later, no worries. Tanvik, please post in the group, okay? Everybody will follow that. And Vrinda also will post, and I will also post.
Yeah, I already closed this one. I already posted.
Where you did not write anything? What did
no,
you
write? I will write it and then I'll send this.
Okay, we have to write it, okay? We'll write it first and then we'll send it.
But
I will send the picture also in the group, okay? You all should.
I already sent it. You can see that one. You can see mine.
Okay, they will see yours also. Okay, don't worry. So, thank you all, kids. Now we will move to the next part of our session.
Cute Raghav. Look at cute Raghav.
Yes, Raghav is very cute. I invite Saroja Nandini Mataji.
Yeah, that's why Saroja Nandini Mataji is very
cute. Rhyme and sloka.
Mataji can make a cohort, Mataji.
Yeah, I will make her. Make her much.
Hare Krishna to all kids. Welcome. We are going to learn chapter 14 of the Bhagavad Gita.
This is Raghav means Krishna.
What is that?
Krishna.
Yeah. So we are going to learn from the 14th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. So is everybody ready? We are going to learn one line.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes, Mataji. Yes, Mataji.
Repeat after me. Mam chayo.
Mam chayo.
Mam chayo.
Mam chayo.
Vyabhicharena.
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 Mam chayo.
Mam chayo.
Vyabhicharena.
Vyabhicharena.
Bhakti yogena.
Enna?
Bhakti yogena.
Avayayo.
Bhakti yogena.
Bhakti yogena.
Sevate.
Sevate. Sevate.
Mam chayo vyabhicharena.
Mam chayo.
Mam chayo vyabhicharena.
Mam chayo vyabhicharena.
Bhakti yogena sevate.
Bhakti yogena sevate.
Bhakti yogena sevate.
Bhakti yoga sevate.
Mam chayo vyabhicharena.
Mam chayo vyabhicharena.
Arena. Bhakti yogena sevate.
Bhakti yogena sevate.
Sevate.
Let's do one more time. Mam chayo vyabhicharena.
Mam chayo
vyabhicharena.
Bhakti yogena sevate.
Bhakti yogena sevate.
Mam chayo vyabhicharena.
Mam chayo vyabhicharena.
Bhakti yogena sevate.
Bhakti yogena sevate.
Okay, can we go to the meaning now? It says, please repeat after me. One who engages.
Hello.
One who engages.
In full devotional service.
Unfailing in all circumstances.
The modes of material nature, and thus comes to level of Brahman.
Okay. And thus comes. The level of Brahman. Okay. So one who engages in devotional service, he comes about the three modes of material nature and he comes closer to Krishna. Okay, so we have to always engage in full devotional service. Don't get distracted to anything else. Just do devotional service completely with your heart. That's what Krishna says in the shloka. Let's go to the rhyme for today.
What new rhyme is it?
Okay, so this is a very interesting rhyme, kids. This is about Ramayana. Okay, a part of Ramayana.
Super. This is for Toby, and this is mine.
Okay, Rama Sita Lakshman went to forest for 14 years.
Then became a wicked lady called Surpanaka.
She was the sister of demon king Ravana. She wanted to kill Sita and marry Ramachandra.
She wanted to marry Ramachandra.
Next,
this again. Rama Sita Lakshman went to the forest for 14 years.
Rama Sita Lakshman went to forest for 14 years.
She was the sister of demon king Ravana.
She wanted to kill Sita and marry Ramachandra.
Okay, so the same tune. Angry Ravan sent a golden
deer to Sita. Mother Sita was in love with it.
Lord Rama chased it.
Tasted. Lakshman went to bring him back. Lala Ma chased Ravana, then came in and took away Mother Sita.
These four lines again. Came from line number 5. We'll do it again. Angry Ravan sent a golden deer to Sita.
Angry Ravan sent a golden deer to trap Sita.
Mother Sita saw the deer and fell in love with it.
Mother Sita saw the deer and fell in love with it.
Lord Rama chased it. Lakshman went to get him back.
Ravan then came in disguise and took away Mother Sita.
Okay, so we will stop here. We will learn the next afterwards. But let's go to the big room now and see who all want to see.
Yes, so there are 8 candles.
How do I join?
So rest of you who are still with me, you can raise your hand.
Unmute Karata.
I want to say it.
Okay, so I'm going to share my screen. So those who want to sing, please start raising your hands.
Here I go.
Okay, can you all see my screen?
No, Mataji.
No, Mataji.
Okay, how about now?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay, so this is the shloka. I'm
going to Mataji.
I'm going to see who wants to sing, and then I'm going to ask one by one. What happened for some reason? Okay, now I can see. Okay, so who wants to go first? Nobody raising hands? Okay, Raghav, you want to sing?
Yes.
Okay, go with the rhyme. First, go with the shloka. Mam chayo.
Mam chayo.
Chare
na.
Bhakti yogena.
Bhakti yogena.
Sevate.
Sevate.
Okay, go to the rhyme. Rama Sita went to forest for food.
Rama Sita. Lakshman went to
forest for 14 years.
Then there came a wicked lady.
Called Shubhanaka. She was the sister of
Demon King Ravana.
She wanted to kill Sita
and marry Ramachandra.
Angry Ravan sent a golden deer
to trap Sita.
Mother Sita saw the deer
and fell in love with it.
Lord Rama chased it. Lakshman went to bring him back.
Lakshman Ravan went to heaven.
Ravan then came in disguise. And took away Mother Sita. Okay, thank you so much, Raghav. Let's see. Who wants to sing? Please raise your hands, kids. Okay, Janavi, do you want to sing? Do you want to do the shloka and the rhyme? Janavi, are you there? Okay, I see.
Okay, Mataji.
Yes, Janavi, please go ahead. Okay, let's first I will go to the shloka screen. Yeah, you can start.
Mam chayo vijata bhakti
yogena
bhakti yogena sevate.
Okay,
Raghunan samati.
Rama Sita, Lakshman went to forest for 14 years. Then they came to a lady called Suparnaka. She was the sister of demon king Ravana. She wanted to kill Sita and my Ramachandra. Angry Ravan sent a golden deer to trap Sita. Mother Sita saw the deer and fell in love with it. Lord Rama chased it. Lakshman went to bring him back. Ravan then came to and took away Mother Sita. More worried Rama, Lakshman went to search of Mother Sita. On their way, they came across Hanuman and Sugriva. Monkey soldiers built a bridge and reached Lanka. There was a battle, and Rama killed Ravana. Monkey soldiers kept keep it up, said Lord Rama. Let us all bring a beast to kill the demons in our heart.
Okay, thank you so much, Janavi. That was so nice. Okay, let's move to Ram. Ram has raised hands. Ram, do you want to do the shloka?
Yes.
Yes, please go ahead.
I want rhymes, Mataji.
I want rhymes, Mataji.
Okay, I'm moving to the rhyme page. Yeah. Go ahead, Ram.
Rama Sita Lakshman and Rama Sita.
Rama Sita Lakshman went to forest for 14 years.
Yeah.
Rama Sita Lakshman went to forest for 14 years. Then there came a wicked lady called Suparnaka. She was the sister of Demon King Ravana, mother.
She wanted to kill
Sita and Mary Ramachandra.
The rhymes went off. Give me one second. There's, yeah. Angry Ravana. Angry Ravan
sent a golden deer to trap Sita mother. Sita saw the deer and fell in love with it. Lord Rama chased it. Lakshman went to bring him back. Ravan then came in disguise and look away. Mother Sita worried.
Worried
Rama. Lakshman went in search of Mother Sita. On their way
they came across Hanuman and Sugriv.
Hanuman and so three monkey soldiers built the
monkey soldiers built a bridge.
Monkey soldiers
built a bridge.
Built a bridge and reached Sri Lanka. The monkey soldiers was a battle on, and Rama killed Ravan. Monkey soldiers keep it up, said Lord Rama. Let's us all build a bridge to kill the demons in our heart.
Hare Krishna Mataji, Deepak. Can I say the rhyme?
Yes, Deepak, please go ahead.
You want all this? Rama, Sita, Lakshmi went to the forest for 14 years. Then there came a wicked lady, Supanaka. She was the sister of demon king Ravana. She wanted to kill Sita and marry Ramachandra. Ramachandra and Ravana sent a golden deer to trap Sita. But Sita saw the deer and fell in love with it. Lord Rama chased it. Lakshman went to bring him back. Ravan then came in disguise and took away Mother Sita. Worried Rama, Lakshman went in search of Mother Sita. On their way, they came across a human and Sugriv. Monkey soldiers built a bridge and reached Lanka. There was a battle. And Rama killed Ravana. Monkey soldiers keep it up, said Lord Rama. Let us build a bridge to kill the demons in our heart. Hare Krishna Mataji, thank you.
Thank you so much, Hare Krishna. That was so nice. Does anybody else want to do it? How about Raghav, Shobhana, still there?
Yeah, Avikni, what does do? I think, Mataji, I think he's too small.
Oh, okay. What's his name?
Avyukt.
Avyukt, okay. Can you please put his name when you join on the call so we can understand?
Oh, sure. Yeah. I'll do that.
Thank you so much for joining in.
Yeah, Hare Krishna, Salubhu. Yeah, sure.
Hare Krishna, Avyukt.
Salubhu, ma'am. He's feeling shy.
Okay, no problem.
Sulukana.
Are you joining first time?
Yeah, Mataji. Actually, I got to know about this class from Devyangi Mataji. She's in Omaha.
Okay.
So she take class for the kids. So then I asked for Avyuk. Then she sent me the link to join this group.
How old is Avyuk, Mataji?
He just turned 4, Mataji.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah. And are you on the Damodar group, on the WhatsApp group?
Yeah. Yes, Mataji, I'm in that group.
Okay, that's nice. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, encourage him to start singing the rhyme and the sloka whenever he's feeling comfortable.
Sure, Mataji. Thank you
for joining.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Okay, so anybody else, any other kid want to sing? Raghav, you want to sing rhyme or do the shloka?
I want to do the rhyme.
You want to do the rhyme? Okay, go ahead. Try the rhyme.
Rama, Sita, Lakshman went to forest for 14 years. Then there came a wicked lady called Shurpanakha. She was the sister of demon king Ravana. Ever ran Sita a gold girl to turp Sita. Mar, Sita, saw the deer and fell in love with it. Lord Ram chased it. Lakshman went to bring him back. Ravana then came and durst and look away mirth with Sita. Well, Ram Lakshman went in search of murder. On their way, they came across Hanuman and Sugriv. Ravana, monkey soldiers, keep it up, said Lord Ram. Let us all blow a big to kill the drones in our hat.
Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you so much, Raghav. That was very nice. And I think we will wait for the other kids to join us back so we can end. I think all the kids in this group have attempted to sing the rhyme or shloka. Does anybody still want to try the shloka or the rhyme? Okay, so then we will have to wait. And
Mataji, Ram wants to try shloka, Mataji.
Oh, okay. Yes, please go ahead, Ram. You can do the shloka. It's okay if you can just do one line. Ram?
Hare Krishna Mataji, it's Deepak. Can I say the shloka?
Okay, before you shloka, I want to confirm, Ram, are you on mute or do you still want to do the shloka?
Yes, Mataji, sorry, we are on mute.
Okay, yeah, please go ahead.
Okay, we can't see the screen where the shloka is, Mataji. Thank you. It's gone again. We can't see the screen, Mataji.
I'm sorry, I was trying to unmute.
Now we can. Bicharena.
Bichayo. Bicharena.
Bhakti yogena.
Bhakti rogena
sevate
sevate
sagunam samatityatitam
sagunam sati
samatit
samatit
yatitam
yatitam
brahma bhuyaya
brahma
bhuyaya
kalpate
kalpate. Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mataji.
Krishna Mataji.
Krishna Mataji. It's Deepak. Can Deepak go?
I'm so sorry, Deepak. It's already time for us to end the call. Can we do it tomorrow? Please be.
Yes, Mataji.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Mataji, thank you.
Solo. 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 Hare Krishna.
Namaste.
Jai. 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 Jai.